what the hell is that for?
It works. Surprise, surprise. Translates into 0.1 of a second slower to 100. Hi. Oh, I'm not loving these tires. What's up, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to this POV review by Autotop.nl. My name is Max, and today we are taking a look at what I think is the ultimate 3 Series at the moment. It is the M340i xDrive Touring, and it is glorious. So today I'm going to show you around it, show you the spec we've got it in, and then we'll take it for a drive towards the Autobahn for an Autobahn blast. But before we begin, don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell if you want to receive updates when we upload a new video. So let's take a look at the spec. We've got a Jerez black car, one of my favorite colors, as you guys know. Right now in the sunshine, it is a very, very dark blue, a deep blue. When it's darker, it turns into a black. It is beautiful, especially combined with all the cerium gray accents you get on the M Performance models, like the front grille with the shower curtain inserts. Every time I drive one of these cars, I'm going to say it to you guys, if you are looking at a 3 Series G20, also take a look at the M Performance grille, the black one, because it fixes the front of this car. What else? Well, we've got the M Performance bumper, of course, with the cerium gray inlay as well. I'm going to do this quickly because I have already done a review on the M340i. And well, it's mainly about should you get a Touring or not. We've also got the standard M Performance wheels, beautiful on this car, with the M Performance brakes, cerium gray mirror caps, black roof rails, black surrounds around the windows, and at the rear we've got an M340i badge. Beautiful rear. I really like this design of Touring. It looks like, I don't know, it just works. It's a really, really good design. And of course you've got the split window at the rear, which means you can access the rear a little bit more easy, or when this is completely full, when you're on holiday or something, you can still reach stuff in here without having to get stuff out and put it in and try to close it again. Trust me, I've read some comments in the past saying that what the hell is that for, but it actually, I have this on my 5 Series as well, and you actually use it when you go on holiday especially. All right. So you guys, oh, I forgot about the exhaust tips, of course. They are the same as on the M340i. They're fake. They're just a bumper part and the real exhaust is in there. And you can actually see the valve there. I don't know if you guys can see that. Let me see if that's the case on the other side as well. Oop. No, okay, so there's a valve in the right tailpipe. And if you put it in Sport Plus, that one opens. And if we take a look under here, we will find the B58 inline 6 turbocharged engine with 374 horsepower and 500 newton meters of torque. It is such a good engine. It works in every car they put it in, including the Toyota Supra. And well, in this Touring, again, it works. Surprise, surprise. And on the inside, we've got, again, a very nice spec with this brown leather. Absolutely delicious, combined with all that aluminium you find in this car. Yeah, it's a beautiful interior. I talked about this before in my 3 Series reviews, that I think that this interior, the new BMW interior, works best in the 3 Series because it feels like a much more expensive, much bigger car. Whereas in the 8 Series, you know, it maybe doesn't fit as well. But in this car, I absolutely love it. So what is the trade-off when you go for a Touring and not for a regular saloon M340i? Well, of course, the weight. You know, this is 100 kilos heavier than a regular M340i saloon. This is 1745, the saloon is 1645. Meanwhile, I'm going to put it in Sport Plus, Sport for the gearbox, traction control all the way off. little sound check. And well, it immediately is very obvious that this is an OPF car and the previous one we drove was not, because that had a lot more sound, a lot more burbles. It definitely was louder than this one. It's really not that loud. It's still a nice sound, I would say, a nice six-cylinder sound. But you don't get those burbles you used to get. So that's, you know, a drawback, but fix that with an exhaust, I would say. But still, I mean, let me show you one of the most impressive things about this car. Okay, we'll put it in sport for the traction control. We've got the gearbox in sport, sport plus driving mode, full throttle, foot on the brake, launch control. Okay. And that is 4.5 seconds from 0 to 100 in a 3 Series Touring. That is freaking impressive. And it's only a tenth slower than a regular one. So that 100 kilos of extra weight translates into 0.1 of a second slower to 100. Hi. Now, of course, we've got the xDrive as standard. There's only one M340i available. It's got xDrive and it's got this automatic ZF 8-speed gearbox. Both are absolutely great. So you don't have to be sad that you don't have a manual or rear-wheel drive. With this touring version, I would say that most of the people would go for xDrive anyway. And this is one of the best four-wheel drive systems available, because in Sport Plus, with traction control off, it sends a lot of power to the rear wheels. It works so well. It's like that MXDrive. This is like an MXDrive Lite version. It's so good, and it allows you to play around a little bit. It allows you to find the limits of the grip without it getting like crazy or scary. And it just means that the car is still a lot of fun. And well, I think that's the most important thing. And it also means that, as I said, as I showed you, you can slide it around a little bit if you push it. And now you're sliding around with a 3 Series Touring. I mean, and it feels like it's absolutely fine doing it. You hardly feel any difference between an M340i Saloon and this Touring, which is just insane. You know, it's mostly down to the fact that you've got that M Performance suspension. It's 10 millimeters. Oh, that was a big one. That was a big one. Can you believe that? That is sending a lot of power to the rear wheels, because that was a lot of lock. But it's got the M Performance suspension, so it's 10 millimeters lower than a regular one. And you just feel connected to the car. It is absolutely amazing. Okay, so a little sound through the tunnel. I am absolutely in love with this car. It's so good. The M340 in general, but this Touring, and in this spec especially, it's so nice. Now, it has to compete with a Mercedes-AMG C43 and an Audi S4, of course. The S4 now being a diesel, so I'm not sure how comparable they are anymore, because it's just such a completely different feeling. The S4 is clearly less dynamic. This is going to take the win if you are looking for something that's, you know, a lot of fun to drive. The C43 is also very nice, but it's a lot less dynamic. It's just, you can't throw it around like you can with this one. Okay, so here we are at the Autobahn. Oh, we can actually get the sport displays going. Maybe you guys think that's interesting. We'll put that in sport and we'll see what we can get. Full throttle. So red line, around 7,000 RPM. Just just before 7,000 RPM. And yeah, it is. That's freaking fast. It's so effortless. It's really crazy that we've come to this level, that this M340i, it's not even a full-blown M car, but it already does 4.5 seconds from 0 to 100. It's the size of a 90s 5 Series, and it handles like a 90s M3. It's really freaking impressive. Of course, you've got all that added weight of today's safety systems and all the comfort stuff. So yes, it is a lot heavier than the older Tourings, but still, the way this thing handles, the way this thing moves, the way this thing moves around is so impressive. And that's the top speed, limited 266 on the speedo, 7, and that should be 250 kilometers an hour. So of course that xDrive system is adding, you know, weight to this package, and I found myself asking, you know, would it have been better without xDrive? Would it have been better if it was 374 horsepower on the rear wheels? I mean, you would shave off, I don't know, 100 kilos from that xDrive system. And I think the answer for me and for other petrol heads and to you guys, the answer would probably be yes, because it would be more fun to drive, you know, on a nice road, and it would feel a little bit lighter, more nimble, and you could slide around even more. But I think to like 90% of people, this actually is the better choice. It's got torque vectoring, it's got a locking differential, it's just got all this stuff to make sure that everyone, and I mean everyone, can drive this car fast. The only downside compared to the saloon we drove, I mean, is that sound. It's definitely a lot quieter. Oh man, can you believe that you could put your children on the rear seat? Ooh. Oh, I'm not loving these tires. These are Bridgestones, and I'm not loving them. That is a lot of tire squeal for, you know, I know how fast I can go through that corner. But I think, you know, a set of Pilot Sport 4S tires by Michelin would fix that problem, because that is a lot of tire squeal. Okay, that was a little sidestep. I'm going to end the review. I hope you guys enjoyed it. You can subscribe by clicking the big button right here. You can also check out this video or go check out this playlist. See you at the next one. Bye.